Well, tonight we're going to focus on a topic that's a little difficult to talk about. We're going to talk about teenage suicide.
And when we saw the numbers, they were really sobering. This recent study revealed nearly 20% of Indiana high school students seriously considered suicide. Tonight, a Rush County mom wants to talk about the issue. This is because her son attempted suicide twice.
Stacy Padgett is lucky. Her son is still alive. Behind the smile in these pictures was a young man struggling because of chronic health problems, a deep depression that led Drew Hahn to overdose on pills.
When I attempted, that wasn't me that attempted. You know, it was something else that had taken over me.
I would have never have imagined that that would have been in his head.
Drew recovered and changed schools, but a year later, he slipped back into depression.
I was to my wit's end, and so I went back and I attempted to take my own life.
What's that like to get that phone call?
It is heart-wrenching. He said, I just overdosed again, and you just go numb.
In the years since that second suicide attempt, Drew helped his mom learn it wasn't anything she had done.
It is a sickness, and it's nothing that they want to do for attention or for selfish reasons.
The shirt from Rushville's First Walk.
Her son got help and then got involved in suicide prevention events.
I couldn't just shove it under the rug. It was time to talk about it and face it. And it was a way for me to apologize for my family for what I've done.
Drew has turned his pain into passion, now talking with young people who've either attempted suicide or have considered it.
I hope and I pray that him being out there can save lives, because that's why he's doing what he's doing.
Sadly, the suicide numbers in Indiana are higher than the national average. In 2015, nearly 20% of Indiana high school students seriously considered attempting suicide. 17% of those kids made a plan.
It's crossing all different geographic and demographic and regional areas. So this is something that's impacting all of our kids.
I would say that we've probably lost 6 people in the last year in Rush County alone.
Here are 3 general warning signs of suicide. Do they talk about being a burden? Does their behavior lead to isolation? Does their mood indicate depression? Those are areas of his own life Drew must monitor.
It's like any other illness. I know I battle it every day of my life. I know, but I'm better now at addressing it.
Do you still worry about him?
Every day. Every day I worry. I worry about him every day. I hope and pray every day that he can get through this day.
We have partnered with Community Health Network. They'll be talking about the warning signs of suicide at the upcoming WTHR Health and Fitness Expo later this month. And anyone in crisis can text HELP NOW to 20121 and get help.